Hey insiders, welcome to the Newsflash. My name is Abhinav and I'm back with a few more updates this week. But before we begin, I wanted to say a big thank you for all the great feedback and some really good tips on last week's video. As Connor noted in one of his videos, it's really tough being a creator and getting used to being in front of the camera. So thank you so much for all the support. This week, we don't have a ton of updates, so I wanted to bring James back to the show, who recently interviewed a Creator Insider viewer who had suggested a specific permissions feature in the comments when James asked about it a while ago. We took his feedback to heart, and we even named our internal project after them, Project Chevy Dude. Not only that, we actually implemented this permission level because we thought it will be super useful to all the creators. So stick around to see that interview. Let's move on to the updates for this week. The very first update is on the rollout of other videos your audience watched feature in Studio. We continue to roll this out and we will keep you updated when this is available to 100% of creators. As a reminder, you may not see this feature now or in the future if your videos are made for kids or your channel does not have enough information. The next update is on audience retention insights. We have now opted in everyone who was eligible and expressed interest in the comments on our 14th July newsflash. You should be able to see audience retention insights if you were opted in the engagement tab of Studio. The next update is on custom emojis in comments. We continue to roll this out and it'll happen over the next 2 to 3 weeks. As a reminder, if a creator with channel memberships enabled has uploaded custom emojis, their members will now be able to use custom emojis in video comments as well as live chat. Now let's move on to James' interview with Chevy Dude. Take it away, James.
Hey, insiders, this is James here. I've got a special one for you today. I'm here with Mike, aka Chevy Dude. Welcome to Creator Insider, Mike.
Hey, thank you. It's a true honor to be part of this channel. I've been watching this channel for a long time.
Yeah, no way. Do you watch every episode or what's your usual habit?
Yeah, no, I definitely watch every episode.
That's awesome. Well, why don't you tell everyone about your channel?
So I am a car salesman in Louisville, Kentucky, and back in 2010, I moved to Louisville, Kentucky from 4 hours away and not knowing anybody, so I decided to start a channel, try to get my name out there, and I created a few videos on how to not get screwed over by a car salesman, and those videos took off. They just went viral. I'm like, what? Hello? This people like this stuff? I was like, I'm not supposed to be trusted, right? I'm a car salesman. So I've taken the channel to the level that people trust me. They have learned about me. They know that they can call me with confidence and say, what he says is the truth. What he says may not be what we want to hear, but we know we're going to get the right answers. And one of the goals that I got into back in 2000 when I started selling cars, because I didn't want to sell cars, is that I wanted to change the automotive industry. And YouTube is now my platform to change the automotive industry.
That's awesome. Yeah, I was watching one of your recent videos and I haven't driven in a long, long time and it made me want to get behind a car. So your channel, is it just you or is there a broader team?
So it's just me on camera. My wife gets involved. We've been trying to kind of launch some podcasting, some live videos. Then I have an editor and then I have a thumbnail person. So, relatively small channel, but I've learned to delegate a couple of responsibilities out to, just make my life a little bit easier because I have the YouTube, which is, we know, is a full-time job. And then I also have me selling cars, which is a full-time job as well.
Well, so the reason, Mike, that I invited you here and wanted to have this conversation with you actually is a comment that you left, I think at this point, probably 3 months ago, maybe a little bit more than that, about permissions. So close watchers of the program may remember that I was on giving an update about being able to reply to comments as the channel owner. And you said something. Now, be honest, before I reached out to you, did you remember commenting this?
Yes, absolutely I did. Because actually, on a side note, some union company saw that note and they put it on Twitter and they were all bashing me on Twitter, which is fine. I could care less if people bash me or not. So that's actually something that I've been wanting for years. And I did remember writing it. It shocked me that you guys actually read it and, you know, started working on it, which is cool.
Yeah, so I'll just read it really quickly. And so Mike says, we need to limit who can see ad revenue and permissions. My editor doesn't need to see how much money the channel makes. I personally think the only person who needs to see revenue is the channel owner. And then whoever the owner wants to see can be a toggle on or off. This has been a request. So I will be honest, Mike is not the first person to make this ask, but it came at a really good time. And I really, that week, we kicked off a project that we internally have been calling Project Chevy Dude. So whether you know it or not, you have been a rallying cry for the internal team since that point in time. So we are launching a editor without revenue role, where you can give someone the ability to access the channel, do almost everything you can do. The two exceptions being they can't delete videos, and they can't see how much any of your revenue data. So they can't go see how much money your last video made in or how much money the channel's made all time. They're kind of there to update, reply to comments, do thumbnails. Cool. Well, thank you, Mike. I think so much for taking the time. Any last words for the insider community you want to share?
No, I think I appreciate everything you guys do, and it's an honor to have you guys read every comment. I know you guys do because I see you love the comments, you know, because I read the comments as well and whatnot. But no, I think it's awesome what you guys do, and just, you know, anything you think of, just do it.
Will do. Thanks for coming on the program. And yeah, we'll more permission updates coming soon. Talk to you soon, Insider Nation.
Thank you so much, James. This was great. Let's move on to trivia. I acknowledge that last week's trivia question got a little confusing, but I'm surprised that still a lot of you answered it right. I asked you, which was the second fastest video to reach 1 billion views, and how many days did it take to reach 1 billion views? The answer is Despacito, and it took around 96.5 days to reach 1 billion views. The winner of last week's trivia is Serena Lee. Congratulations. For this week's trivia question, I'm adding a different flavor. This is my ukulele, which I love playing whenever I'm stressed. It helps me relax a little. This week's trivia question is, how many different types of ukulele are available in the market? And what is the distinguishing factor between them? Bonus points to anyone who can tell me if there is one ukulele which has a different tuning compared to all the others. I am signing off for this week, but I'm really excited to see you all again next week. Stay safe. Have fun.